So again we are with assess economic chapter 17 economic problem and challenges, poverty and unemployment. We have already gone through poverty. Now the major and the most we can say important factor that India is facing nowadays, we can see more dangerous than coronavirus, is unemployment. As you all know, you have gone through this thing, unemployment. You can just go through in our society, in our region, and see this problem creates. And by this, you know, many effects are there of this thing. So let's begin with the unemployment. On page number 139, among current problems of India, problem of unemployment is crucial. The first line insists us. Crucial. Poverty originates due to the unemployment. This is a long-term problem and has got deep-rooted in economy. Maximum countries of the world are facing problem of unemployment. Not only in India, in maximum countries of the world are facing this problem. But we Indians are facing it too much because of the ratio of population. Day by day, minutes by minute, second by second, our population graph is going up in the world. Some countries are there is no population. Even in Japan, if you marry and have a boy or girl, government used to pay $70,000 to you. So in some countries, government is giving lots and lots of money till the boy, even the free education, lifetime for the kid. So you can understand, but here we are facing a crucial problem. Even the world is facing, but we Indians, our India is facing this demon. So let's go. Meaning of unemployment, what is the meaning? Please underline this thing. One who is adult, whose age is 15 to 60 years, who is ready to work at the prevalent market rate of wages, has energy and qualification to work, who is in search of work but is not getting work, such a person is said to be unemployed. So understand that 15 to 60, a person is physically fit, has knowledge, wants to work but didn't get work, then this is called, and the such person is called unemployed. Such type of condition in group is called unemployment. Such an unemployment which has to face mandatory call is called unemployment against has wish. Why is it an has wish? Unemployment against his wish or has wish. Please, this query I would like to solve, but not in front of you. Individually, I will be there if anybody asks me. People who demand wages more than the prevalent market rate, who are not in age group of 15 to 16, who are handicapped, weak, sick, or old, lazy housewife, those who are not willing to work in spite of being capable, are not considered as unemployed. Obviously, those who are disabled, working woman, means housewife, you are not able physically to work over this, so you are not interested, even we can say, are not coming in unemployment. Now, types of unemployment, how many types of unemployment are there? Let me go through this lesson, how much big it is. Sorry, I had not seen this thing. So let's continue and let's begin with the types of unemployment. What are the other types of unemployment in Indian economy? Seasonal unemployment due to lack of irrigation facility, irregularity in rainfall, and lack of alternative employment. Farmers have to remain unemployed for 3 to 5 months in India. This is called seasonal unemployment. As I have earlier told you, that due to some period, the farmers and their correlated members, you can say, those who are based on agriculture, agriculture businesses over there. 2 to 3 to 5 months they are unemployed because lack of rain somewhere, yeah, a time period between 2 or 3 crops is there. Frictional unemployment, when New technologies introduced in place of old technology, laborers remain unemployed for some time. This is called frictional. Frictional, for a certain time we can say there is unemployment section if a new technology comes in a way. And to understand it, it takes a time, and during this time duration is called frictional unemployment. Structural unemployment, Indian economy is backward and unorthodox. Social backwardness, traditional orthodox customs, illiteracy and lack of structural facilities are responsible for structural unemployment. The structural, we can say, as you all have gone through the structure, there must be a particular type of structure over there. As the world changes nowadays, day by day, minutes by minute, upgradation is coming over there. To understand, these people are having a particular type of orthodox system. And to maintain, to cover that system, they need a time, and even some of them they accept and some of them don't. So this type of structural unemployment comes due to illiteracy, orthodoxy, we can say due to some traditions, to customs which are they deny to accept all these things. So it comes, it creates structural unemployment. Now this huge unemployment, what is this used? Sometimes more than required number of workers are involved in an occupation. Even if few laborers are removed from work, no decrease is recorded in total production. So these extra laborers are said to be unemployed in this used way. So for a particular task, example, we need only 50 workers, but 100 workers used to do that task. 50 workers can easily complete that task, and the remaining 50 are called, when they are thrown off, they are called disused unemployment. Now industrial unemployment. In the industrial field, if anyone has to remain unemployed for the short term or a long term due to changes taking place in industrial sector, such a situation is called industrial unemployment. Industrial, for a particular time due to changes to the upgradation or upgradation of the industry, there is a lack of time, little bit, there is a time period to remain, to continue this all works regarding industry, and this type of time creates industrial unemployment. Educational unemployment, if a person has obtained at least secondary education or degree and is unemployed, he is called uneducated unemployment. That the world, that the India is facing today, there are educated people, but there is no employment. So such type of people, those who holds their degree but are not in work, are not able to get work properly, it is called educational unemployment. Now, proportion of unemployment in India. What is the proportion? What is the proportion of unemployment in India? What does proportion mean? Proportion, which type of, which stage, which strategy we can say, which parts that of unemployment? Let's go in. There is a difference in state-wise condition of unemployment in India. State-wise, peoples are different. Proportion of people are different. So, because of indifferences of employment exchange in registering the details of people interested in getting job, it is difficult to take out exact of actual or approximate figure. Still, on the basis of figures of Labour and Employment Ministry of India and National Sample Survey (NSS), we get an idea about comprehensiveness of unemployment. It is impossible to get the particular average of the person, those who are unemployed. Because if you are, for example, in survey time you are unemployed, but within, after the survey, the next day you are employed, then, but through average survey, it has been marked over there. According to census counting of 2011-16, million people were in search of employment, 32 million people were uneducated unemployed, and 84 million were educated employed. approximately 4.70 crore people of 15 to 24 age group were unemployed. So you can understand that a particular age of you and me, you are the young India is unemployed. Then what happens? The young India is unemployed, then what it will be in the situation? So according to that, according to the survey of Labor Bureau 2013-14, rate of unemployment in India was observed to be 5.5% and in Gujarat per 1,000 people, 5.4%, and in Gujarat per 1,000 people, 12%, 1.2% were unemployed. In 2009-10 per 1,000 people, 34%, 3.4 were unemployed in urban area in India, while in rural area, 16 people, 1.6% were unemployed. Ratio of educated unemployment was more in urban area. Rate to educated unemployment was more in urban area. Rate to unemployment in the woman was 7.7% in 2013. So you can understand, you can go through these all figures, that how much of unemployment people are there in according to the rural and urban area too. It was a survey of 2013 or 2014 or 2015 or so on. But now it is 2020. What will be the survey and what will be the figure of this unemployment in India as you had gone through? Apart from this, for the 6 months or so, we are having this particular time, crucial time of COVID-19. So you can understand what will be the strategy, what will be the scenario of the people, and lakhs and crores of people are unemployed and facing poverty. In India, more unemployment has been witnessed in states like Sikkim, Kerala, West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jammu, Kashmir, Tripura, while ratio of unemployment in Himachal Pradesh, Haryana, Karnataka, Chhattisgarh and Gujarat has remained low. Condition of employment in Gujarat is good and noteworthy. According to an estimation, 50% highly educated people are youth, 66% youth of the world, who are youth of 35 years of age live in India. If India wants to become superpower on the basis of youth, it will have to change unpleasant from the unemployment. So you can see that maximum age rate of India is up to 35, means there are lots and lots, crores and crores of youngsters, those who are in India. So if India wants to be a supremacy, India must have to kill the demon of unemployment. As per our many states are there, where there is lots of poverty and unemployment there, but we can develop because we are in that level of the youth age. Main reason responsible for increasing unemployment in India are increase in pure population, theoretical knowledge only, lack of practical knowledge, lack of technical knowledge or skill failure is providing complete employment, irregularity rainfall in agriculture area and more risk closing in the time, interest in agriculture sector, improper irrigation facility, lack of alternative employment during time other than agriculture season, weak condition of cottage industries, household industry and small scale industries, caste system, joint family system, people are forced to follow the traditional business or family business, lack of courage to set up a new business, flaws in knowledge, skills training and experience, immobility of labor, flawless planning of labor, low growth of industrial development, test rate of service tendency, thus decrease in rate of capital creation was a new business in industry can be set up due to lack of investment. So what are the main reason? The main reason, as I told earlier, is population. Main reason, there are the righteous rules and regulations in the societies. Apart, illiteracy, lack of knowledge. Technically, the persons are not in good sense. No doubt they got the knowledge, book knowledge, but technical they are. So lots and lots of things. Apart from caste system, creed system, improper irrigation facilities, unawareness, illiteracy, many, many factors are cause or responsible for increasing of unemployment. How to reduce this thing? Effort to reduce unemployment. What efforts government is to take here? What efforts we have to do to reduce this unemployment, especially for our country, our motherland, India? What we have to do? What are the reasons for that? Let's go a little bit. Problem of unemployment is the weakest link of our plan. Poverty and unemployment are the two sides of the same coin. Both are interrelated. Main reason for poverty is unemployment. Obviously, this challenging problem has mainly affected educated youth. As a result, they lost altitude of interest towards studies, negative efforts of social and mental condition is seen. They become disappointed psychologically. If they remain unemployed for a long time, they get involved in antisocial or immoral activities. The most dominant thing that affects is, first of all, loss of education, population, and this unemployment affects the youth, those who are educated, because if they don't get for a certain time any employment, they divert their mind towards the unnecessary business, they get mentally or psychologically they are affected too much. So this all creates a problem. If they remain unemployed for a long time, they get involved in antisocial or immoral activities, example drug trafficking, illegal activities, robberies, recovery, ransom, etc. Increase in social and economic inequality is there. Class discrimination begin fall in living standard. When price rise joins unemployment, condition of the poor and unemployment becomes more narrowing and pathetic. He turns towards narcotic drugs and other addictions. Thus, unemployment has proved to be deadly for individual families as well as company economy. We have studied about plans of government to remove unemployment while studying about poverty alleviation programs. Let's recall them. Other than the main effective steps have been taken by the government, which are as follows. As we have gone through the different schemes, yojanas of government for removing poverty, the same criteria, the same system is implemented over here. Just recall it, and some other points are there to go through it. By aiming high goal, economic development of 10% per year, which is acceptable to all, increasing capital investment opportunities of employment, new fields should be opened for fast and balanced economic development, along with development in agricultural sector, small houses, old industries, cottage industries, etc. And in order to increase employment, government has to start giving economic help, education, open training center through different schemes. So in terms of agriculture, as we are dependent upon agriculture, most probably our Indian people, the Indians are dependent on this sector, that is agriculture. So there must be development, there must be training, there must be schemes, more and more information towards the youth, to the unemployed person, by giving them lots and lots of facility. This can be developed. You can see that many while going through FB or some Instagram or something else, with Google, if you will go through, you can get different videos how China is developing, how Israel. You know, Israel is developing. You just can't imagine in the field of agriculture. Before a few years, as I have told in your class, I don't know, but Before few years, some Israeli officials came towards the river Saraswati that is nearby my house. They came there and they told, yes, we can grow your tomato within a week. There is no water in the river Saraswati. Though they told that we can grow tomato, we can grow potato, we can grow many, many vegetables in this land, there is sandy land, and that also within a week or two. So you can understand how much developed country it is Israel, how much development in the field of agriculture. Total, first of all, it was not an agriculture based country, though today it stands at the topmost level, one of the topmost level in the field of agriculture, and new schemes, new start, and many, many things that is covered with it. So India, as you all know, it depends upon agriculture. So there must be improvement in the schemes, in the facilities, in the public centers, and many, many, many things we can say. Now, next, government should lay stress on development of units using labor-intensive method for production of consumer goods, small and cottage industries, gramodyog, handloom, and handicraft scale. For it, encouraging policies should be implemented in the scheme. So government must develop, yeah, reduce stress in development. Many, many, you know, cottage industries, just like handlooms, yeah, making pots and making this, you can go through in Kutch, the business of making particular type of, you can say, handicraft industry. This have been ruined. So governments must low down, first of all, the stress of the people, their workers, their unemployed persons over regarding to this industry. Not only agriculture, many other cottage industries are there. Government must encourage them, give them employment, facilities, schemes. Awareness is the main thing. We are not aware of the things. If once we are aware, no doubt we will take our first step and we will be succeeded. Now, number third, more number of people may be employed in rural area by less investment by developing new method at the rural level, in which more than one crop may be taken from the field in order to remove unemployment during a time when farmers are not engaged in agriculture, to bring new land under cultivation. Arranging water and electricity for every field, small and big irrigation scheme, dam, check dam, ponds, canals, tubewells, activities of construction of road, activities related to agriculture, poultry, fishery, cattle rearing, dairy industry, programs of afforestation. For this planning should be employed oriented. Employment opportunities should be increased in villages so that villages get enough income and work in their own village, so migration towards cities may be reduced and pressure and demand of unemployment may be decreased. Encouraging plantation, agriculture, organic farming, dry farming, and multi-cropping ground, growing vegetables and fruit, importance should be given to improvement of quality of education in villages. Superb. Government can do this all things. They can encourage farmer, because we got a particular type of period where the farmer is not busy in his work and there is unemployment, as we had gone through earlier in some points of unemployment, that the farmer is facing the problem of unemployment, and the co-related workers, though are in agriculture, face a particular type of unemployment. So many facilities can be given to grow vegetable, to do other industry, agriculture based works over there. Many, many things can be done regarding this unemployment. So, and for that they need awareness, they need schemes, they need support from the government, etc. In order to sustain human development in rural areas, health, education, pure drinking water, nutritious food, electricity, road, banking, insurance, internet, improvement in communication and entertainment, water harvesting activities, constructing permanent public property, development of local industry and encouraging them adopting employment oriented programs should be undertaken. Quality life of rural people as well as result oriented improvement has been the main objective. Very important point for you. Again I would like to read on page 142 that in order to sustain human development, how we can develop, how a human can develop, in order to sustain human development in rural area, health, education, pure drinking water, nutritious food, electricity, road, banking, insurance, internet, improving in communication and entertainment, water harvesting activities, construction of permanent public property, development of local industries and encouraging them adopting employment oriented programs should be undertaken. Qualitative life of rural people as well as result oriented improvement has been the main objective. The main objective is the facilities. Main objective is the awareness of these all things. For example, banking, insurance, call center, we can say that the people, the unemployment person can get the benefit of the government scheme. He can know different departments like food, water, clean water to drink. So many depends upon the health of the particular person over there. Many development of local industries can be done. Constructing permanent public property. This is so many schemes are there within this thing. Many of the villages of India has been changed more than we can say more updated than Palanpur. Many villages are there where Wi-Fi is free. People are connected, each and every house is connected with internet. Even some villages, the gas connection is being given free. So because they implement the government schemes and get money, all are aware, each and every public, each and everyone are aware of this thing, of what is the government need, what are the government schemes and how to indicate this all thing, how to intimate these schemes, how to keep you it in implementations of these things. So many schemes are there, awareness programs are given by the government, just what we have to implement it. We have to make in use. Many such villages are, though no doubt they are in India, the many of the students like you has given their life to the village and has developed a new India as their village, as they develop their village. So till here I would like to stop, otherwise you all will bore even I too. But these all things are necessary to be studied as you are the youth of India, the upcoming India. Till that, thank you very much. Thank you.